Hi, today we are going to see about telemetry. What is telemetry? So from the word we can understand that actually telemetry, which is comes under communication field. So telemetry in the sense, it is nothing but we are just going to transfer the information from the transmitter to the receiver. So how we can send the information from the transmitter to the receiver, that is what we are going to discuss in the next slide. So telemetry, which is nothing but it's a highly automated communication process, that is what I already told you. It's a communication by which we are just going to measurement, that is we are going to meet. Not only that, we are just going to collect the data from the remote location and we are going to transmit from the transmitter to the receiver. And while you are going transmitting the information, not only we are sending, we are doing monitoring, then we are going to do recording, then we are going to analyzing the concept. So three things we are using by the way of telemetry process. So we are just transmitting the signal from transmitter to the receiver, we are monitoring the thing, recording the thing, and we are going to analyzing the concept. Okay, so here while you are going for telemetry, what are the different methods of data transmission? So the data is transmit depends on the variable as well as the distance, that is very much important. So variable in the sense whether you are going to sending the signal in terms of voltage or current, right? So these are like variables. Distance in the sense whether you are going small, large, very large, right? It is like you are going for something like a kilometer or more than that. That is what distance. So this is how the data transmission depends on the variable as well as the distance over which the data has been transmitted. And there are three different types of transmission: hydraulic, pneumatic, electrical and electronic. There are three ways of transmission. General telemetry system. What is general telemetry system? So the first block is about your measurement. You all know what is measurement. The measurement, which is nothing but the unknown thing, that is this is what we are going to measure. So here your physical variable we can call it. So the physical variables in the sense, it is nothing but pressure, level, speed or flow, any physical variable. Okay, so that has to transmit to the sensing part. So primary sensing element. So this particular block, which consists of sensor as well as transducer. Okay. So can we have what are the different sensor and what are the transducers? So suppose I want like the input I have taken as a pressure, so I have to go board on. Okay, if I am going my input is temperature, then I have to go thermocouple. Okay, if I am going any flow measuring, then I have to use float. So according to my input variable, I have to choose the sensor as well as transducer. So sensor, which is nothing but it will sense the information and it will transmit. But transducer means whatever the non-electrical parameter, non-electrical quantity, that will be converted into electrical quantity. That is what your transducer. So whatever the data you are getting here, if I am using thermocouple, I will get the voltage millivolt. If I am using any bodon tube, then I will get a signal in terms of displacement. So according to the input, the value of my primary sensing element range will get vary. So according to the range, I have to go for manipulation. Okay, so after manipulating the thing, I am going for transmitter. So this transmitter and the receiver, there is a called channel. What is that? Because here it will do the decoding part, right? Here it will do the encoding part, because we don't know how many signals you are going to send. So decoding, in the sense, suppose like I am using some decoder, the decoder which consists of 2 power n. If there isn't 2 input, your output will be 4. Encoder, just ulta, if 4 input, that will be output is 2. Okay, so that is how the channel, the telemeter channel, which was the interconnection between the transmitter and the receiver. And here we have the, according to the transmission of my particular data, either I am going for decoder or I am going for encoder, that has to select. Then finally the data will be getting into the end device. So the end devices may be analog or it may be digital, or it's like any voltmeter, ammeter, or any display devices. So these are all the components were present in your end device part. Okay, so that is what my block diagram of telemetry system. Then types of telemetry system based on the the signal concept. The first one is landline telemetry. The second one is radio frequency telemetry. So in landline telemetry, there are three things. The first one is voltage. That is, my signal is in terms of voltage. Then my signal is in terms of current. Then my signal is in terms of current, or my signal which is in terms of position. So based on these three, position, voltage, current, it comes under landline telemetry. The next one is about radio frequency, that is because of the range. Okay, so that is how your landline telemetry and radio frequency telemetry are classified. Then what is RF telemetry? RF telemetry means it is purely based on radio frequency signal. So in the transmitter and the receiver, there will be no physical link between transmitting and the receiving station. And the transmitter, it consists of your radio frequency modulator. And the modulator is again whether you are going for amplitude modulation, or you are going for frequency modulation, or you are going pulse code modulation. There are various different types. It depends on the signal. Either you are concentrating on amplitude, or you are concentrating on frequency, or you are concentrating on the position. This is one way. The another way is whatever the bandwidth you are going to choose. The next one is about your cost. So based on that, you have to choose the RF modulator. So modulator means what? It is a combination of your input. That means your input signal, that is your original signal, plus your carrier frequency. That is what actually call it as a modulator concept. Then for the receiver section, you have a demodulator. So demodulator means I am just going to separate it, the carrier frequency, from the original signal. That is what demodulator. So the demodulator is again how you are going to choose, either it is amplitude or you are going frequency. Okay, so generally in RF telemetry system, which consists of three things, that is there will not be any link, then RF modulator, then RF demodulator, and for manipulating the thing, we need a amplifier circuit. So this is what my block of radio frequency. So the first, the general block diagram, what we have discussed, the same thing only, physical variable, that is your measurement. Then you have a transducer, Then signal conditioning. In signal conditioning, either you can go for amplification, or you can go for filtering concept, or you can go for clipper, or you can go for clamper. Whatever the manipulation you want to perform, that will be signal conditioning. Then it comes to transmitter. Your transmitter block, which consists of two things, that is modulator as well as amplifier. That's all. Then we have an antenna. Then receiving part, the same way, we have a demodulator and the amplifier. These two blocks we used to call it as a receiver block. Then here also we have a signal conditioning. Then the output display part, you have an end device. This is what my radio frequency telemetry block diagram. So what are the modulation scheme? Just we have discussed in the previous. Just I want to explain to you. That is, the first one is your amplitude modulation. What is amplitude modulation? Amplitude modulation, this sense, it is nothing but only there will be an amplitude variation. You can just look at here. This is what generally this part we used to call it as an amplitude. So here the amplitude is low, here it is high, then here it is low. Okay, so this is what my amplitude modulation. Frequency modulation, the sense, which is nothing but there will be a variation, because if I am drawing like this, this variation, this is what frequency. Okay, then pulse modulation. That is pulse in the sense it is like an zeros and one variation. But phase modulation means it is nothing but variable frequency with the base band signal. You can just look at this diagram. There will be an amplitude, you can see they are like the variation between this particular component. But here you can just look at the frequency is also getting varied. So here they are just varying the frequency along with base band signal. That is what phase modulation. Then digital modulation, we have again four types: amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, phase shift, then quadrature, phase shift key. So whatever, according to the application, the people used to go for either analog modulation or digital modulation. If it is analog, then they are choosing either AM or FM or PM. If they are going digital modulation, whether they are going ASK or FSK or PSK or QPSK, this all the variation depends on the application. Okay, so you can just look at, there is an amplitude shift, right? Here it is frequency. Amplitude is similar. Then here only the phase variation. Then quadrature, phase shift, in the sense both there is a variation, right? Your amplitude, frequency, and here also some shifting. No, this is what actually called as an quadrature, phase shift, key. You can just look at both these. Both this phenomena were not present. Here it is a linear line. So that was the difference between your PSK and QPSK. Look at these two diagrams. Here the variation is only the amplitude. Okay, it's going, coming down, upper. But here the frequency one, you can just look at the distance. Here, here, this is what frequency shift keying. Okay, so this is what radio telemetry talks about. The application, we can use it wherever you want to transmit the signal. Defense, phase, then swimming pool, water management, agricultural, space science, wherever you want to transmit the information, then the people transmission to the receiver without wireless, this radio frequency telemetry system is using. Okay, thank you so much.